see here in this match?
What you're going to see is the most suicidal, the most homicidal, the most genocidal athlete that's ever appeared, not just on Raw's War, but also in Extreme Championship Wrestling, the Lord of the Hardcores himself, Sabu.
All right.
Making his way to the ring.
How's that? Not bad, huh?
That remains to be seen.
Sabu
coming by his manager, Bill Alfonso. Of course, many fans remember Bill Alfonso as a former referee and a pretty good referee in his day, as a matter of fact. But right now, he is managing Sabu. And what is Sabu's relationship with a man that we are familiar with, Paul Lee, Mr. Monday Night? Well, who is Sabu?
Sabu is the nephew of the original Sheik. And Sabu competed in Japan and in India. And as you will see by the footage that I so graciously brought to you, Sabu is probably the most dangerous athlete on the face of the planet today. And Sabu came to ECW on October 1st, 1993, main evented on our first pay-per-view against Taz, and will be on August 17th, Hardcore Heaven 97, against the Sandman on our second pay-per-view. This man defies any description that you can label him with.
Why is his body so scarred, Paul? What's caused that? He's got scars all over himself.
This man has paid a price that very few, if any, would be willing to pay. He dives into barbed wire. He is the Lord of the Hardcores. And although I don't personally agree with the man, I used to manage him myself. He is Rob Van Dam's partner, but he is without question. Watch this.
Great leverage coming off the ropes. Spinning heel kick, and out goes Flash Funk. They have met before, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, look at this.
They've met before in the ECW arena, and now Sabu.
Somersault punched by Sabu. I tell you what, you talk about suicidal. That's the best description of this athlete I think you can give him.
He's going for it now. You know, Eric Bischoff can tell you that the Public Enemy invented tables on national TV, but I can tell you, as the man that discovered the Public Enemy, they stole the entire deal with the tables from that man, Sabu, the originator of the broken table. And tonight on Raw, he is going to put Flash Funk through a table. I personally guarantee it.
Sabu from ECW, along with Flash Funk, getting it on live, ladies and gentlemen, from Detroit, Michigan. A little bit later on, live. Whoa, what a maneuver that was. He won't get up from that one. Well, I guess he does. Live later on, The Undertaker teaming up with the man they call Vader to square off against the new Nation of Domination. All that and a great deal more coming up. But right now, Sabu with the advantage. And Sabu, look at this. What a hurricane rana! A springboard hurricane rana by Sabu!
Is that enough?
Nope. And Flash Funk kicks out.
Flash Funk is no spring chicken. This is one unbelievable athlete. And he is going to be on the top of his game tonight, because he's in there with a man that he knows will take it to the extreme.
Here's another look at it.
You know, Bill Alfonso was a referee for you for a long time. We adopted him from the Betty Ford Clinic.
Really?
Really.
That's nice to know.
He graduated with honors twice.
Oh, there you go.
He's very proud of it, as a matter of fact.
Should be. Anyone who graduates from there should be proud.
Many longtime fans certainly remember the antics, the unpredictability, the danger perpetrated by the original Sheik. Sabu is the original Sheik's nephew.
Stop!
And look at this. What?
What
a clothesline! And Bill Alfonso with the ubiquitous whistle.
Ubiquitous.
And oh yeah!
Great kick, a great martial arts kick by Flash. You're seeing two athletes live here in Detroit. Turn it out. Turn it on. So you ought to turn it up.
And you're seeing your man get brought to the extreme. You're seeing a whole new Flash Funk tonight, because he knows he's in there with a dangerous, dangerous competitor. And you're welcome for bringing a new fire out of Flash Funk tonight.
That was a very tactical move there. A drop kick right to the knee. Right to the knee there by Sabu. Good move by this unorthodox competitor.
Oh, he's not just suicidal, homicidal, and genocidal. He is a capable, capable athlete, and he knows what he's doing in the ring. Just ask Taz, who was taken all the way to the limit at barely legal to pay per view.
Watch this. From the top and down. Little riding high, but nonetheless, two and.
Oh!
Sabu just barely able to squeeze out.
You see what the ECW wrestlers can do for the World Wrestling Federation? We're bringing out a whole new Flash Funk for you tonight.
And I hope you understand what the World Wrestling Federation can do for you.
Oh!
Hey, that's why you see me here. That's why you don't see me on Nitro. That's why I brought ECW wrestlers right to Raw.
Oh, look at that maneuver. Great move. A great move.
I don't knock what you guys offer us. I appreciate it very much.
And we appreciate it very much.
Mutual admiration.
So everybody appreciates everybody. I don't know who's going to appreciate this table.
The things get out of hand sometimes with your ECW performance.
But that's the way we do Raw's War. This is not a walk through the park. This is not a picnic. This is what it's supposed to be. Greek cut tables like you'll see elsewhere.
It may be academic, but both men have been counted out.
He's going to bust that table, I promise you. He's going to bust it if it kills him.
Oh, no. I think it killed him.
So what?
If not,
that's extreme. That's hardcore. That's why we do pay-per-views. We're too extreme for Monday night. We're too extreme for Raw. I warned you about this. You should listen to me sometime.
Move on, ladies and gentlemen. Triple threat match coming up. World Wrestling.